I think it's very cultural that if we were in India, we wouldn't have talked to anybody about this, and we would have dealt with it ourselves. I started off with that because this is how I was conditioned, I guess. So once we found out that he had cancer, I was dealing with it on my own. I didn't tell any of my friends. I didn't tell my relatives. And I was trying to deal with it on my own, and I thought I really didn't know what to do. So my sister called. She was in India, and she called. She said, "So how are things?" And I said, "Everything is fine." So and then I was at the hospital one time, I remember, and he had a big lump coming out of his throat here. And the doctors suggested surgery, and also from that surgery, they would do the biopsy. So, and I was sitting outside waiting for that surgery, and I could hear the doctor talk, and I could see him, and I was in tears. That's the time when I realized, you know, I can't do it on my own. I need people to talk to. And then next time when my sister called, I told her about that. Then she called her husband here, and this is how the ball got rolling, and I started talking to people, and they were so supportive, and I wasn't the same person then, because then I got the strength from them. I had people all around me, they were helping me, and this is, again, I would strongly recommend that please reach out. There is help available, and people should go and reach out. Don't just keep it to yourself. It's not going to lead you to anywhere.